一声哨声，这场练习赛
Welcome back. You're watching Inside and a really painfully slow soccer game, but bear with the clumsy footwork as robotics tech in China continues to grow at a blistering pace. Now, these humanoid robots are still far from taking on Lionel Messi, but this game played in Beijing over the weekend was seen as a breakthrough for robot kind and artificial intelligence. And that's because their movements weren't remote controlled by anyone on the sidelines, but by built-in algorithms. And for the record, the winning team came from Tsinghua University.Meanwhile, Chinese startup Notix has seen orders race ahead after its N2 humanoid robot took second place at the Beijing Marathon's robotics showcase in April. Founder Jiang Zizhuan spoke exclusively to Bloomberg about the company's growth and how it plans to navigate tensions between the US and China.
The biggest change to our company is that we sold over 2,500 robots to our consumers after the race. The second biggest change is that a lot of media and investors are coming to our company to interview me or my team and to invite.
How much are you looking to raise right now?
We're looking to raise over 250 million Chinese yuan in the newest round of fundraising.
What valuation are you doing that at?
The newest round of raising of our company, we are valued at $200 million.
Before the humanoid robot race took place, what was your valuation?
Before the marathon race, our company was valued at, in Chinese yuan, is 500 million, 500 million Chinese yuan. It's like 70 million US dollars.
And so 2,500 robots essentially since the robot race, what does that mean for your annual production capacity and is that changing?
This year we are building about 2,000 robots and next year we plan to build over 10,000 robots and we will be, we want to be the first company in the world to produce more than 10,000 robots.
So today Notix robots are sold in China. When would you...look to expand abroad and where would you go to in particular?
We'll start our global sales in like October or after. We target to sell our robots to North America and Europe and Middle East.
The products that you use or the components in the humanoids, are they sourced from China or do you also need to source productsor components from other parts of the world?
Most of the parts of our robots are manufactured in China, but there are a few parts of the robots that are from global suppliers. Like we are using the STM32 chip in our joint motors and our communication boards. We are using Intel chips in the computer of our robots. And we are using Intel RealSense camera in our robots to see the surrounding environments. Besides these, most of our components are manufactured in China.
But on those products that you are using, and particularly from the US, do you have any contingency plans in place if the US were to further restrict China's access to technology?
Yes, like the STM32 chip, they can be replaced by GD32 that is manufactured in China. And we are now testing the Rockchip CPU to replace the Intel CPU in our product.
Do you see a scenario then where you're not using any technology from the US?
So I think we should embrace technologies from all parts of the world. We are thinking about the extreme situations and we are having plan Bs for that situation.